Welcome back, bachateras y bachateros. There's a problem every bachatero faces when they go out dancing, and that's asking other people to dance. On the other end of the spectrum, perhaps you're a lady, and you're not getting asked as much as you like to because you're putting yourself in situations where it might be difficult for men to approach you. We'll be discussing this from both sides, and we'll start with the bachatero side because that can be a little bit more complicated. After that, we'll move on to what the bachateras can do so that our dumb monkey brain can understand if the lady wants to dance or not. Besides the obvious signs that she may want to dance with you, we will review some of the signs that you may have missed either because you didn't catch it or maybe you just didn't have enough experience. I'll be providing bachatera probabilities based on my experience for each situation. But do keep in mind that there could be several factors for why she could say no, and those are most likely beyond the scope of this video. My rating will be from 1 bachatera being the lowest chance, and up to 10 bachateras being the best chance of dancing. You'll find that these tips will help you no matter what level you're at. I've personally seen some amazing dancers that they didn't ask a girl to dance because they lacked the courage, where they didn't properly read the room, even though it was quite obvious that the lady was waiting for him to ask her to dance. First, let's begin with signs that she may want to dance. There's a lot of variables to consider here, but we're gonna start with the easiest scenario where we'll assume that you're asking ladies to dance at a dance club. If you don't know what I'm talking about, check out my other video. Within the dance club, there are several locations you need to keep in mind. First, there's the dance floor, the bar, the tables, and the DJ booth. From there, we will focus on the social situations, such as the male and female group, the potential couple, and the clique. First is the dance floor. This is quite obvious, and I'd say that most of the ladies that are on or near the dance floor would like to dance. I'd give this 9 bachateras. The more bachateras, the better your chances. Notice that it isn't guaranteed, but you should still put your best foot forward and ask. If you're at a dance club and she has a drink in her hand, and she's standing by the dance floor, this situation can be a hit or miss. She may be rehydrating herself for a quick second, or she could be taking a break for about a song or two. I'd say the odds of her wanting to dance are about 8 bachateras. So go out there and ask her to dance. Let's say you're about to order your drink, and she already has her drink. She just finished ordering it, and you hear a really good song come on. Curse you, DJ! I must you play with my feelings. So you have no choice but to ask the closest bachatera. If you stop to analyze the situation, you'd realize that you have about 5 out of 10 bachateras of her actually wanting to dance. And that's being generous. Most ladies by the bar are taking a break, or perhaps they're looking to relax and just kind of chit-chat for a bit. From my experience, even when I asked some of my friends to dance by the bar, it was pretty hit or miss. So as you might have guessed, this is not the best place to look for a dance. This exact scenario that I've described has happened to me many, many times. Curse you, DJ! Why must you play with my feelings? Now let's discuss the table. You might find a bachatera sitting down at the table and maybe she has a drink in her hand. This can be tricky, but chances are that if the table is next to the dance floor, she's probably looking to dance. If the bachatera is sitting at a table and that table is far away from the dance floor, then she probably does not want to dance. Common knowledge is not so common. For the first situation where the bachatera is sitting at a table that's near the dance floor, I would say you're looking at around 7 bachateras. She may want to dance, maybe she wants to rest. Who knows? You're just gonna have to ask to find out. The second situation is tough. I would give it around 3 bachateras. This situation isn't as clear. Perhaps she's there because all of her friends left their stuff there. Maybe she's shy, or maybe she's trying to rest and she's trying to get away from everyone. Who knows? Who really knows? But if there are no other bachateras around, then you might not have any other option but to simply ask. Next, let's talk about the DJ booth. This may be one of the trickiest and most intimidating places to ask someone. In this situation, we're going to assume that you don't know anyone. Perhaps you're in a different city, state, or country. Obviously, if you're in your home turf, it's gonna be a little bit different, but we're just gonna assume you don't know anyone. Unfortunately, the DJ booth and cliques are kind of like salsa and chips. Where you find one, you'll find the other. From my experience, most people standing by the DJ booth are kind of cliquey, and they'll only dance with people that they know. That's not always the case, though. Sometimes they might just be shy, or perhaps they know the DJ or their friends are hanging out by the DJ booth, so they're gonna be there, right? Because they know them. This is one of the great mysteries of the dance club. In any case, most people at the DJ booth are still there to dance. However, because of the clicky nature, I would say that the odds are about 7 bachateras, and that's on a good night. It can be hit or miss depending on the crowd. Your best chance is to make a good first impression. This is where we cross into the social aspect. People are complex, and there could be several factors why a bachatera wouldn't want to dance with someone. From my experience, most teams fall under the clique category as well. A group of ladies is another potential clique, but it's not nearly as bad as the DJ booth. Chances are that if you find several ladies on or near the dance floor, or maybe they're sitting at a table that's close to the dance floor, at least one of them is going to want to dance. Overall, I give this situation a rating of about 8 bachateras. If the group consists of both males and females, then I'd say you're looking at a score of about 9 bachateras. Finally, we have the potential couple. Not all couples are like this, but there are a few that refuse to dance with anyone else besides their significant other. If they're holding hands, don't ask. If they're cuddling together, don't ask. If they're making out, don't ask. Common knowledge is not so common. If you find that there's some space between the two of them, or maybe one of them is talking to other people, then they might be okay with dancing with strangers. Overall, this situation is tough, and I'd give it about a 1 bachatera score. Other factors that could prevent ladies from dancing with you could include that maybe she's intimidated, maybe she just started dancing and she doesn't feel confident enough or comfortable enough to dance with other people, or maybe she smelled you from a mile away. Watch my hygiene video. Now let's discuss the opposite situation from the bachatera's perspective. For the ladies, if you find yourself in a situation where most guys are either ignoring you or maybe you're putting yourself in social situations where the guys can't approach you, put yourself in social situations that increase your chances of being asked. I personally find myself asking a lot of the ladies that are on or near the dance floor. This location earns 9 bachateros. If you're at a table that's near the dance floor, that's about 8 bachateros. If you're with a group of friends, this is also about 8 bachateros as well. If you're with your significant other, this will be a lot tougher for guys to ask you. The best chances are when I see the lady asking maybe her friends to dance. This lets me know that she's okay with dancing with other people. So I'll ask her. This social situation is still about 5 bachateros. Mostly because maybe she only wants to dance with her friends. Who knows? The only way to know is to ask. But that's what I found at least. What did you guys think? Did you guys find this useful? Maybe I dug too much into this, but whatever, I hope it helps someone out there. Like and subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and I'll see you guys on the dance floor. Maybe next year, or in 2, I don't know.